All right. We are starting with the revision of term one again. Okay. We have finished the syllabus of HTML for the board examinations, right? And I'll be continuing with the cyber ethics chapter in the upcoming week, right? So Abhi, practically you people will start revision of HTML along with me. Okay. Starting from the very first topic of HTML, right? So parallel type along with me. Whatever I will type, you parallel type on your BCs. Starting with all the recording is going on. Don't interrupt in between. Whatever you want to say, just raise your hand. We have four basic tags or the structural tags of HTML. Okay. First is HTML. HTML tags marks the beginning and ending of HTML document. Okay. There are four basic or four structural tags: HTML, head, title, and body. Then we have head tag. Head tag is used to specify the style, the script, the description we used in the web page, and it is the tag which encloses the title tag within it. Title tag is enclosed inside the head tag. What is the use of title tag? Title tag is used to specify the title which will be displayed in the title bar of the browser window. You got my point? Whatever title you will be giving here, title will not be displayed in the browser window as a part of web page. It won't be displayed as a part of web page coding. You will just see the title in the title bar of the browser window. Like I'm giving the heading revision one. And one mistake which you people commit: don't enclose the title in double quotes. Okay. 10th class, don't enclose the title in double quotes. Keep it as it is. And enclose the title tag. Clear? Am I clear to all?
Yes.
Here, close the head tag. Now we start the body tag. Body tag is the tag which contains actual content of the web page. Right? All the formatting tags are enclosed inside the body tag. So these four are the structural or the basic tags of HTML. Vivan, I think you are sitting on the personal PC. So concentrate on your work. Now, every tag has some attributes. Attributes reflect certain properties, certain extra information about the tag. The tags which have both opening and closing, they are called container tags. The tags which have only opening but no closing, they are known as empty tags. Right now, all the four structural tags, they are container tags. Okay. If any tag contains any attribute, attributes are always written inside the opening tag. Okay. Like, for example, the first attribute of body tag is BG color. BG color attribute specifies the color to be displayed in the background of the web page. Suppose in the board examination, you get a question of 1 mark. What is the use of BG color attribute of body tag? And you people have given the answer: it specifies the background color. You will get no marks for that. BG color attribute of body tag specifies the color which will be displayed as background in the web page. Clear? Answer ki formation ka bhi dhyan rakhna. Cut short answers mat likhna board examination mein. Your concept should be very much clear to the examiner. whosoever will check your paper in the board. Don't give incomplete answers. Okay? Equal to, give any color. I am giving aqua. Okay? Then, I want to display the heading of my web page. Headings are always prominent, and to specify the prominent headings, we always use heading element tag. There are total 6 heading element tags: H1, H2, H3, H4, H5, H6. Which is the largest? H1. Which is the smallest? H6. Okay. So I am specifying H1 here. The only attribute of heading element is align. Right? So I am specifying the align attribute as center. Okay. I am giving the heading syllabus. I have given the heading syllabus. Okay. Now, heading is in H1. It will be displayed in the center of the web page. But I want the heading should be colorful. For that, what I'm going to do, I'll be applying the font tag. Font tag is a tag that specifies the style, the color, and the size of the particular segment of text. Ab kyunki maine heading already H1 mein di hui hai, so I don't want to specify the size attribute of. So I am specifying here font color equal to red. Okay. And face attribute. Beta, in your IT files, please pay attention here, online and offline class. Many of you have written style as attribute of font tag. In your projects, you have done this thing. Style is not an attribute of font tag, it is face. So, this is the color of my text, and this is the style of my text. Now, coming down, I want to display the list of topics for the syllabus. Okay. So, I begin with the OL list. OL list stands for ordered list, it is also called numbered list. Okay. And the attribute of OL list is type, and the default value is 1, 2, 3. Your list will be displayed in the proper sequence. In order list, a proper sequence is followed. Whether the sequence can be in numeric form 1, 2, 3, it can be in alphabetic form ABC lower or ABC capital or Roman lower or Roman capital, as per your convenience. I am specifying normal ABC lowercase. Right? Now, my first concept is term one. I close the list item. Okay. Term one, I have HTML. Basics. Okay. I have cyber ethics. Right. I have HTML forms. Right. I close the order list here. I close the order list here. Okay. Now I want to. Okay. I want to change the color of the text. Okay. So I'll be closing the font tag here, right? Then again, I start the font tag with the color attribute as green, right? And I close the font tag over here. You can specify the size of list. Size I am giving 5, right? Clear? Here I close the body tag. And finally, I close the HTML tag. Online class, am I clear up till here? Yes, Tanya, Vanita, Hardik, Akshit, Gitanshu. Hardik, are you here in the lecture? Roll number 12, Hardik. Bhanu Pratap, Lakshay, Parth. Concept is clear. All right. Tanya, send me attendance of the class after the lecture, okay? So now I'll be saving this web page under documents. I'm giving the name revision1.html. Okay. Now I'll be viewing the browser view. This is my file. Shh, shh. See, I increase the zoom level. I change the background color. Okay, clear? Is the browser view clear to the online class? Offline class, your coding is done. Is the browser view compatible with me?
Yes.
All right. Now I tell you some extra work. Underline the heading. Heading should be underlined. And one horizontal rule must be drawn after the heading and after the last option. After the heading and after the list, one HR will be drawn. The color of the first HR should be yellow. The color of the second HR should be blue. So to draw the HR, what we will do, we will take HR tag, horizontal rule. What is the use of HR tag? HR tag is used to draw a horizontal line across the width of the web page. It is used to divide the web page into different sections, right? So I am giving the color yellow. Size I am giving 4. One HR, and HR is empty tag. Don't close the HR. And here I am giving again one HR, color equal to blue, size equal to 4, right? So I have drawn two HR, one after the heading, second after the list, right? And as I told you, HR is an empty tag. What I mean by empty tag? The tag which does not have any closing tag. Very right. So let us go with the browser view. See, Am I clear? Any doubt, any queries in the first revision part? Daily beta, I'll be revising some part of HTML so that you are totally in touch with the HTML, okay? And daily practice one program at home, at least one program. Online class, any child assessing Zoom class from laptop, can please show me the browser view if you have typed the coding parallel. Beta, please don't speak anything. I'm showing the coding part again. Check it out. Am I clear? Any doubt? Okay. Text is not so clear, so I changed the background color to silver. Right? Okay, now view it. You can make your heading underline by adding U tag opening and U tag closing, right? So this is the complete web page. Clear? Now same list you can represent using different type of alphabets or numbers that can be used with the order list. Like capital A, B, C. This becomes the list in capital A, B, C. Then you can specify small Roman. Okay. This is small Roman. Then you can specify uppercase Roman, this is uppercase Roman, clear? And if I am not giving the type attribute, my question is silent regarding the value of type attribute, by default, list will be displayed in 1, 2, 3. See, the default value of type attribute is numbering form 1, 2, 3, likewise. So agar aap type attribute nahi bhi doge, by default wo 1, 2, 3, 4 mein print karega. Am I clear, 10th class? Any doubt to any child? Yes. Yes, online class, any doubt? Now, let us go with the next list, that is unorder list. Unorder list, as I told you earlier also, it stands for your unordered list, where no proper sequence is followed. Okay? No proper sequence, no proper order is followed. Randomly, the items are arranged using bullets. Clear? Now, bullets can be of three types, disc, square, and circle. The default bullet used with the unordered list is disc. Type equal to disc. If you are not specifying the type attribute, by default, it will be in the solid dark circle, that is disc form. I have to close the UL also. Let us see the browser view. See, solid dark circle appears. Clear? Now you can change the value if you want. You can give square also. I'm giving the square value. This is square. Then you can specify the next bullet, that is circle. See, disk means solid dark circle. Circle means circle without any fill. Without any fill color. Okay. Daksh, please avoid. Daksh, avoid. Any doubt? Yes, online class, any doubt?